In this video, we're going to cover T-walls for multi-story structures. This method will follow the single-story method almost to a T, except for one key difference in the way we brace the wall. First, to connect our T-wall to the straight wall, we'll make a cut on one side of the straight wall block equal to its core size. Depending on the location of your T-wall, you'll have to cut one or two webs away from the foam to make this cut. When doing so, make sure to leave the saddles intact so rebar can still be placed. Next, shim off the last 2.5 inches of teeth on both sides of the cut. This will allow the next course of block to lie flush on top of the first course. Next, cut 2 inches from our T-wall block to create a minimum of a 2-inch overlap for the next course of block, and ensure the nailers will line up each course. Instead of strapping the back of the straight wall, like you would do for a single-story structure, we'll place an extra 5-foot piece of number 6 rebar on the opposite side of your L-bar each course. We also recommend zip-tying it in place for reinforcement. This way, you won't have to worry about strapping the back side of the wall all the way up a multi-story structure. This 5-foot piece of number 6 rebar, placed each course, will take the place of any strapping you would put on the back of the structure. This is the key difference between T-walls for single-story structures and T-walls for multi-story structures. All other elements will be the same. Next, to help support the integrity of the wall during the pour, use a wire tie to connect the T-wall to the straight block. The wire tie should cover 2 to 3 webs on the T-wall and connect to either the rebar or the web on the straight wall. Next, place your L-bar. Your L-bar is going to alternate each course to reinforce the T-wall juncture. Alternate its placement, both on the direction of the bend in the straight wall, as well as alternating its placement on either side of the web saddles. For the second course, the T-wall block is now going to lie flush on top of the first course, instead of butting up against it. For this, we'll need to make our straight wall cut an extra 2.5 inches on either side. We'll also shim off the last 2.5 inches of teeth from the T-wall block. Our L-bars are alternated, as well as the wire reinforcement, and we can continue this same process for each course, alternating between the T-wall block butting against the straight wall block and lying flush on top of it. We recommend using 1x3 strapping for the courses that butt against the straight wall, meaning the first, third, and fifth. Just to reiterate, no backstrapping is needed because of the extra piece of number 6 rebar placed every course. This is our recommended way of completing T-walls for multi-story structures. If you need to review the single-story method, a link to it has been placed in the description below. Thanks for watching, and if you have any further questions, please give us a call.